Today, we make the pizza. Facciamo la pizza!
Alright, here we go. We're going to take a little bit of all-purpose flour. Take a little all-purpose flour. We're going to dust the surface. Get everything out of the way. We're going to dust our work area. Now, I don't like to use a whole lot of flour. A lot of people kind of dunk their dough in flour before they work it. I don't like to. I think it's cheating. And it kind of leaves a weird dust on the crust. Dust on the crust. That was my band in the 1980s. Anyway, so here we go. We're going to take this 3-day-old, cold-fermented, outstanding, fantastic, amazing... Oh, I wish you guys could smell that. Dough. We're going to put it... Oh, now see, you got to work fast with high hydration dough. Good to good dough is good to know. And good to good dough is a sticky dough. So here is a sticky dough. We're going to kind of roll it out. Important to make sure that your dough comes up to room temperature real easy with the dough. Comes up to room temperature before you start working with it. Otherwise, it's hard to work with. It doesn't get oven spring. It's not good. So I'm keeping, I don't know if you can see this. Can you see this on this camera? Okay, so I'm keeping a really, really wide correzione crust on this, so it's going to be nice, fluffy, and puffy like pillows. And I'm not going to make it very big, because these are not big. Now see, that's a little too thin. See that? Too thin. We're going to fix it. We're just going to go nice and light. There we go. Nobody ever know. So we can do the old Neapolitano slap. That's looking about good. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay, so we're going to stretch this out again when it gets on the peel. But I just want to get a little more. Well, we got some problems with it. We got a little bit, a couple holes in the dough. Okay, so now we're going to take the sauce. Now, I use my grandma's ladle. This is my grandma's ladle. Check this out. Is that cool? I don't know if you can see that. That's my grandma's ladle. You could use any ladle you want. I like to use my grandma's ladle, and it has special powers. It holds 3.7 gallons of sauce. Actually, no, it doesn't hold 3.7. It holds this many ounces. So, little start in the center. Then we work our way out. Now, I should tell you, my oven setup is also important. We want to keep stuff away from the center, out to the edges. Now, what I'll do is I'll take this... Take a little fresh oregano, I call it. Okay, or as they say in Ireland, oregano. Here we go, so a nice little sprinkling of that. Take our pizza peel. Now this is where timing and time is really important. Take a little semolina, it'll work fast. Sprinkle that peel with some semolina so it slides off nice and easy. Take the pie. Slide it right on there. Now we stretch. Stretch a little bit more. Okay, now she's going to go in the oven. And this is why you want to have all your ingredients ready, because we got to move fast. Why not make it? We try to make it as round as we can. I really don't care. I like it irregular. Like I like my cheese and my friends. Here we go. In the oven, on the steel, middle rack, preheated for an hour. Now, start the timer. And now we wait. What else is going on? I got nothing. It's only been a minute. Sometimes I'll take a little fresh basil and I'll soak it in the brine of some fresh mozzarella. Some fresh mozzarella brine. That way, when you put the basil on the pie, it does not burn, but it still retains moisture and it has a little bit of that mozzarella flavor. Oh, fantastico, it's molto bene. Pro tip. Oh, let me go into my home oven setup. That's warm. All right. Through many, many, many different setups, trials and errors, and flubs and close. What I come up with is this. I got a pizza steel and a pizza stone. Now the pizza steel is 3/8 thick and it goes in the middle rack. The pizza stone goes on the rack above it and it creates a little bit of a mini oven because it's got heat radiating from the top and that pizza steel maintains temperature longer and it's a faster recovery so I can make pies. I go from one shelf to the next. You'll see what's going on in a second. So that's my setup. I have it on broil. Got to preheat that sucker, get that thing as hot as it can get. I kind of tricked my oven out. I don't recommend doing that. I would not do that. Do not do that. Do not alter your oven at all. However, I like to get my oven as hot as it can possibly get. So I keep it on broil. I preheat that thing up for at least an hour. At least an hour. So usually while I'm preheating that, I'm getting my other stuff ready, prepping a little bit, and then we're ready to go by the time the oven's hot. Also, dough. Make sure that you keep your dough at room temperature before you start working. It's chewy. It sucks. Okay, where are we at? 237. All right. At 3 minutes, we are going to take this pie out of the oven, put the low moisture mozzarella on it, and then we're going to put it back in for another 3 minutes. And 3 minutes. Watch. Out it goes, working fast. Working fast. Now, we don't want this thing to be like super cheese, so I gotta be careful. This might be a little too much cheese. Is there such a thing? I don't know. Fire alarm. All right, start this up. I'll be right back. Okay, sorry about that, guys. That happens every time I cook. These fire smoke detectors are really sensitive. Don't unplug your smoke detectors. Just work around it, use it, you need them. Okay, where are we at? I don't know what this is doing. Is this recording? I don't even know what's going on, guys. I'm telling you guys, making this pizza is the easiest part of this whole thing. Here we go. This video might turn out really bad. I don't know, but another 3 minutes in with the low moisture mozzarella. Now 3 minutes, we're gonna pull that out. We're gonna put the fresh whole milk mozzarella on, drizzle with olive oil, basil, and we're gonna finish it on the top rack on the pizza stone. It's gonna work, trust me. I've tried this not a million different ways, I've tried it probably 13 different ways. This is the best way to do it, trust me. Closing in, 5:45. Try not to open your oven too many times and check on it in between because you want to keep that hot. As soon as you open that oven, the temperature drops. No bueno. Non è buono. Here we go. Now this all depends too on how wet your dough is. If it's wetter, it's going to take longer. If you're using a drier dough, it's going to go quicker. So let's check it out. It's perfect. Now, what you should see at this point is almost looks done. Let me see if I can catch it here. Okay, so it almost looks done. You got starting to get some brown. I don't know if you can see the bottom? This is gonna be tricky. Alright, see the bottom? Look, it stays on. Beautiful. Okay, here we go. This is working, guys. Alright, now we're gonna take the low moisture mozzarella. It's a little cheese forward already, I can tell. It's a little too much cheese. So maybe we're gonna go easy on the fresh mozzarella. Is this recording? I think so. All right, this is too much cheese. I don't want to hear it, you guys. I know it's too much cheese. I know. You ain't gonna tell me. You go cook yourself. Okay. It looks good. Guys, this is gonna be one cheesy pizza. I usually don't make it that cheesy, but it is what it is, and it's gonna be delish. Here we go. We're gonna use some of this. Pizza Margherita is just so beautiful to look at. It's a gorgeous looking pizza. So, here we go. Now when this is done, I like to throw a little fresh, dry basil on because I'm a big fan of basil. All right. Oh, drizzle olive oil. I got a little six on there. A little heavy on the olive oil. That's fine. We just dab it off. Not a big deal. We don't panic. We don't cry. We adapt and overcome. Here we go. So, back in. Another 3 minutes. On the top, on the pizza. I forgot to turn my pizza stone back over. Hold on. Here we go. On the pizza stone it goes for 3 minutes. Maybe a little longer now because I let a lot of heat out. A lot of hot air in here. All right. So we might do another 3 minutes. Might be a little longer. Now this time we could check it because the bottom's done. Got some nice leoparding. It's nice and crisp. Now what we're doing is kind of finishing it on top where the pizza stone is not going to have that much heat. It's still going to be hot, but it's going to be cooking the top pretty evenly with the bottom. Now, if you find that your crust is kind of overdone already and you just want to melt the cheese, what I do, and I'll do it for you here. I don't know if you can see it on camera. Anyway, I'll top it in my broiler. Open the broiler with the pie on the peel, and I'll just kind of wave it underneath the flames of the broiler. I got to get down on my hands and knees and do it. It's a little work, but it's worth it. Now, what that does is it just crisps up the top, cooks the top, leaves the bottom alone. Pro tip number two. God, I'm hungry for this pie, guys. Whew. I guess at this point is when, if you wanted to Americanize it a little bit and start putting toppings on, you could probably put, I would put the pepperoni on when I put the low moisture mozzarella on. And then maybe the whole milk fresh mozzarella on top of that would be, ooh, that'd be good. Sausage, if it's already cooked, I'd probably put it on in the last 3 minutes just to kind of heat it through. You don't want too much of that grease going into the pie. Anything else you could top at the end. I might put a little anchovy. I like a little anchovy. Don't judge. I like anchovy. I'm gonna put that on there maybe. Got another minute. I was trying to set this up earlier, and I got all kind of rigs, and I'm setting it up. I'm like, oh, okay, perfect. There we go. Let's see here. You know what I got? What I got here, guys? A little dolly, little inadvertent dolly shot. Production value. Yeah, I got 30 seconds. I'm gonna check it. Oh, it's looking good. Okay, so that's why you can't always rely on the timer, because sometimes things move. This one moved, baby. Hold on, look at this. Look at this pie. Look at this pie. Is that beautiful? Goodness. Here we go. I'm going to take it over here. Guys and girls, look at this pie. I hope this works. Hope this autofocuses. Look at that pie. Okay, so look at the crust. Look at this crust. Okay, all right, this might be a very cheesy pizza. Not surprising, coming from me. So let's cut this bad boy. Woo-hoo, let's cut it and eat it. So I would probably take this and I would char the basil a little more. Actually, I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna char the basil, and this is when I'm gonna top it in the broiler. So I'm gonna pop open the broiler, and I'm just gonna tease it underneath the flames of the broiler just till I start to see a little bit of char on the basil.
When the moon hits your eye like a bigger pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore.
Whew! Okay, just a few seconds in the broiler. Right under there, just kind of waved it in there, not 20 seconds. And check this out. Little bit, but big difference. Let's cut. Listen to this crunch. Oh, can you hear that? this pie is... Oh, you can smell it and see it. Oh, is this going to catch? Oh, I know. I'm going to top it with a little bit of fresh basil. I like basil. I'm a basil guy. Basil guy. I like fresh basil. Boost it up a little bit. Ooh, a little booty booty. Don't tell anybody I did that. Here we go. Little base. On the base. Put the base on the base. Here we go. Oh. I'm getting a little teary. God, that's good. A little too much cheese. A little too cheese forward. But it's hard to judge. This is what we do. We work, we learn, we bake, we learn, we mess up, we learn, still enjoying it the whole way through. If I were to do it again, what I would do is I would probably cut the low moisture mozzarella in half, or even put a third that much amount. I mean, this is really cheesy. I don't know if you can see that. That is a lot of cheese. If you like a lot of cheese, go for it, baby. You know, I am not a pizza snob. If it tastes good to you, put a pineapple on it. I don't care. Put a bike tire on it. Whatever floats your boat, man. So I would cut that in half and increase probably the amount of fresh mozzarella by a third, maybe. It's all about balance. You don't want pizza overwhelming you with cheese or sauce or dough, but this dough is really good. This is a good pie. I give it about a 8. 8.5. Until next time, guys, go cook yourself.